not the foundation for marriage. This statement will cause problems. I know it will. Because we normally get married to someone because we say we are in love. Can I suggest to you, please, after being married for 32 years myself, had a very, very happy marriage. Not a bad day for 32 years. Can I say to you that love does not make marriage work? Don't be fooled by that. Whether it's a feeling that you say you have for someone, or an endearment to someone, if someone tells you good things. Don't get married because you love someone. I love aircrafts, but I can't fly them. You can love something, but know how to do it. So it isn't love that's the problem. It's knowledge to function in that. Let's talk a little bit about love in this session. Love does not keep marriage together. And I believe every divorced person here will agree with that statement. If you are divorced today, that means you were once in love with the person. So you didn't lack love. There were some other things that came up in the relationship that were stronger and more powerful than the love. Whether it was infidelity, unfaithfulness, whether it was abuse, physical abuse, or emotional abuse, or mental abuse, or whether it is neglect or irresponsibility in finances, something came up that became more powerful than the love you had for the person. Which means that love can save you. It's tough, isn't it? Write this down, please. Successful marriage is a result of the application of knowledge, not the exchange of love. You can be in love, young man, all you want. It doesn't make the woman the right woman. You can express your passion to this man all you want, but that love for that man will make him the right man for you. And we need to get this fast, because you see, in the book of Proverbs, verse 4, chapter 4, verse 7, it says, wisdom is supreme, so get wisdom. And in all you're getting, don't get love. Get what? Understanding. You want to understand what it is to be a woman, what it is to be a man, how to live with a human. You want to understand the idiosyncrasies of a female and the uniqueness of a male. You want to understand communication skills. You want to understand how to manage emotions and how to handle anger. You want to understand the dynamics of disagreements. You want to understand how to handle unfaithfulness, broken trust. You want to understand. Because if you don't understand those things, you're going to dump that marriage. Many marriages today could have been saved. I'm sure of it. But the individuals didn't have the equipment, the knowledge to use to fix the situation. No marriage is irreparable, believe me. But most people either don't know, or they're just so tired trying, they quit. And believe me, problems can make you tired. And this is why it's important for you to get understanding. I like what it says in the book of Hosea, chapter 4, one of my favorite verses in the Bible. It says, my people are destroyed for what? A lack of knowledge. Now, here's the part you always miss. It says, because you have what? Rejected knowledge. I will also reject you, says the Lord. God is saying that ignorance is a choice. Here's what's important here about this verse. You cannot reject something that was not available. bookstore in his book. And you sit there and you got hell at home but walk past the bookstore. Do you know that all your problems that you're facing now are probably solved in a book in your house you haven't read? We reject knowledge. Have you ever sat in a session like this and you hear this kind of teaching and your first thought is, boy, he should have been here. Oh, they should have been here to hear this. What you're saying is, they missed it. They rejected opportunity to get knowledge. And God says, because you reject knowledge, I also then reject you, because I can't help you with what you don't know. And then he says something very important. He says, and you cannot be a priest before me. You see that there? The word priest means representative. God said, I don't want you to represent me if you are stupid. I don't want you to go to tell people you know me and you dumb. Stop saying praise to the Lord and you can't handle your life. You haven't gotten the material to represent me and they tell everybody you know me. He said, don't tell anybody about me, please, because you are messing up my reputation. Here's the worst part. It ends with this. And I must also reject your children. What God is saying is, write this down. Ignorance is generational. What you don't know is transferred to your kids. So if you can't stay married and get it right, you got to be careful, because your kids may also be in danger of having the same problem that you had. Can you always remember this? Learn for your unborn children. Read a book for your unborn children. Go to a seminar for your unborn children, because that's what it's about. The less you know, the less they can learn. The more you learn, the more you can teach them. Because when you have information, you can transfer it to your children. God says, you need to get understanding and knowledge. Thank you.